Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a free, complete course for the CCNA 200-301. If you like these videos, please subscribe to follow along with the series. Also, please like and leave a comment, and share the video to help spread this free series of videos. Thanks for your help. Let's get started. In this lab, we'll configure IP addresses on a Cisco router. This is like the demo topology I used in Day 8's main video. I just changed the IP addresses. We still have one class A network, 15.0.0.0/8, one class B network, 182.98.0.0/16, and one class C network, 201.191.20.0/24. Let's get started. The first step is to configure R1's hostname. I haven't done any configurations yet on R1, so it still has the default hostname of router. Let's go on to the CLI of R1. Now I'll use enable to enter privileged exec mode. Then, to configure the hostname, we have to be in global config mode, so conft. Now let's set the hostname. Hostname R1. Okay, you can see the prompt changes to display the new hostname. That's all for step 1. Step 2 is to use a show command to view a list of R1's interfaces, their IP addresses, status, etc. Do you remember what command that is? It's a very helpful command which you'll use a lot as you configure Cisco routers. It's show IP interface brief. But, as you can see, the command doesn't work. Why is that? Well, it's because show commands are normally done from privileged exec mode. However, let me use the up arrow to return to the previous command, then I'll use the shortcut Ctrl A, so hold the Ctrl key and press A, and then the cursor returns to the beginning of the line. Then type do in front of the command, and now it lets me enter the command from global config mode. Now you can see a list of interfaces, their IP addresses, which are unset at the moment, and their statuses. Remember, the status column indicates the layer 1 status. Currently, their status is administratively down, because Cisco router interfaces have the shutdown command applied to them by default. The protocol column indicates the layer 2 status of the interface. Because layer 1 is shut down, layer 2 can't operate, so they are all down. We will configure Gigabit Ethernet 00, 01, and 02 in this lab, so they should all become up afterwards. Step 3 is to configure the appropriate IP addresses on R1's interfaces and enable them. We are also instructed to configure appropriate interface descriptions. Let's start on the Gigabit Ethernet 00 interface. Just for this interface, I'll type out the whole command. Interface Gigabit Ethernet 00. There we go. As you can see, the prompt has changed to show that I'm in interface configuration mode. Let's configure the IP address. Once again, I'll use the full commands for this first interface. IP address 15.255.255.254. Now, what's the appropriate subnet mask for a /8 prefix length? It's 255.0.0.0. Now let's configure a description. I'll indicate that this interface is connected to switch 1. Description, I'll put two hashtags, to switch 1, and then again the hashtags. You can use different descriptions if you want. This is just how I do descriptions. Finally, let's enable the interface. No shutdown. Immediately, I get two messages indicating that the interface has come up. Before checking on the status of the interface, I'll configure the other two interfaces. To switch to configuring another interface, I don't have to exit back to global config mode first. I can just type interface G01, and now I'm in interface config mode for Gigabit Ethernet 01. Let's set the IP address. IP address 182.98.255.254. The subnet mask for a /16 prefix length is 255.255.0.0. And the description. description, hashtag, to switch to, hashtag. Let's enable it. No shut. Okay, now let's go to the last interface. Interface G02. IP address 201.191.20.254. And the subnet mask for a /24 prefix length is 255.255.255.0. Next, the description. Description, hashtag, to switch 3, hashtag. Finally, let's enable it. No shut. Okay, since we're done with the configurations, I'll use the command end to go back to privileged exec mode. Alternatively, I could have used the exit command twice. Once to return to global config mode, and then a second time to return to privileged exec mode. Now let's check on the status of the interfaces. Show IP interface brief. Now you can see the IP addresses we configured, the method lists manual instead of unset, and the layer 1 and layer 2 statuses of the interfaces are up and up. Now step 5 says to view the running config to confirm the changes, and then save the config. Show running config. Here are the interfaces. You can see the descriptions and IP addresses we configured. Notice the default duplex auto and speed auto commands. Also, if you look at the VLAN 1 interface, you can see the shutdown command, which as I said is applied by default to Cisco router interfaces. Okay, let's save the config. I mentioned in a previous video that there are a few ways to save the config. Copy running config, startup config, write memory, or just write. I like to use the shortcut version of write, WR. There we go. Step 6 is to configure the IP addresses of PC1, PC2, and PC3. I'll go on PC1 first. To configure the IP address, click Config up here. First, notice that I pre-configured the gateway here. I'll talk about what the purpose of the gateway is when we talk more about routing, but notice that it's R1's IP address. Now, to configure the PC's IP address, click on Fast Ethernet 0 here, that is PC1's network interface card, and then here you can configure the IP address, 15.0.0.1. And look at the subnet mask. It automatically fills in 255.0.0.0 since this is a Class A address. Okay, now we can exit out of here. Let's do the same on PC2. Click on PC2, click Config, click on Fast Ethernet 0. The IP address is 182.98.0.1. And once again, it automatically fills in the subnet mask. This time, 255.255.0.0, because this is a Class B address. Now let's go on PC3. Click on PC3, click Config, Fast Ethernet 0, IP address of 201.191.20.1. And this time, the subnet mask is 255.255.255.0 for this Class C address. Okay, finally, let's go back to PC1 and try to ping. Click Desktop, then Command Prompt. Now I'll try to ping PC2. Ping 182.98.0.1. Okay, looks like PC1 can reach PC2. How about PC3? Ping 201.191.20.1. Great, PC1 can ping PC3 as well. So, in this lab we looked at how to configure IP addresses on router interfaces, how to configure interface descriptions, and how to enable interfaces with the no shutdown command. We also configured IP addresses on PCs in Packet Tracer, and confirmed reachability with ping. That's all for this lab. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and share the video with anyone else studying for the CCNA. If you want to leave a tip, check the links in the description. I'm also a Brave Verified publisher and accept BAT or basic attention token tips via the Brave browser. That's all for now.